In this clip, we will only use three apps. For videos under 2 minutes, we will only need the first program, PutMask. For videos that are more than 2 minutes, we will also need a video editing program to paste the 2 minute pieces from PutMask together. Here we will show the program Filmigo. In the case of a long clip, Filmigo will export the clip with a large file size. If you want to send it on WhatsApp, the maximum file size must be 64 megabytes. Thus, if your file is larger, it must be compressed by a video compression program. Here, we will show the video compressor Panda program. First, we go to Google Play Store and download these three applications. Then, we open PutMask and briefly press Select from Gallery once. We then select the video from the gallery. Here we see that a selection of maximum 2 minutes can be made. We can shorten the selection by pressing one of the arrows and pulling it towards the left or towards the right. For now, we want to select the first 2 minutes. We press Continue. From the first frame, we see that we have all the faces visible in the frame, so we can press Detect and Track All Faces, then Start Detecting and Tracking. We see how the green lines, the trackers, go through the whole clip. The clip changes from dark gray to colored. This means that the program was able to detect the four faces along the entire length of the clip and automatically put a mask that pixelates the image over each face. If we click on the eye, it will show us a preview of the video with blurred faces. We now press Edit, and then we press the eye again to exit the preview. We will see that some green squares with numbers appear over the faces. If we press Play, the squares will move with the faces. It is important to scroll through the video to see if the program has correctly selected the faces for the entire duration. If we want one of the faces not to be blurred, we stop with the tracker, i.e. the green line, at a frame containing that face, then we click once on the green square. Then we press the trash can. This means that the mask has disappeared until the person's face is covered or their back is turned. Then the mask reappears and we have to repeat the action. When we have finished the whole clip, we press export. If we have a clip of 2 minutes or less, we're done. We can find the file in our library, where the program automatically created a folder named PutMask. For a clip that is longer than 2 minutes, go back to PutMask, search for the original clip again, and this time select only the last 30 seconds. Here we see that the first frame is black. It does not contain any faces. We press briefly on the triangle with the dash on the right to advance in the clip by one frame, until we reach the first frame that contains faces. Then we click Detect Faces, OK, select all, and start tracking. Here we see that the trackers did not go throughout the whole clip, so we will press play and pause when the green squares disappear from the screen, then repeat the process throughout the clip. After exporting, we will go to Filmigo and press Editor. First, we will click on the 2-minute clip, then on the 30-second clip, in order for the program to add them in the correct order on the timeline. Then we go to Export, choose the resolution settings we want, and click on Export. Here, it tells us where it saved the file. It will appear in the main menu in Google Photos. If we look at the details of the clip and see that it is too large, we open Video Panda Compressor, select the clip, and choose what settings we want, then press Compress. When it's done, press Save. We can choose to create a new folder for Panda. It can be accessed from our library.